So, hello everybody. We are gonna have some Saturday Advent of Code. I am really surprised I got up on Saturday. So, let's see. Stream processing. Oops. Stream processing. Is not safe to cross the stream. It's full of garbage. Eric, hello. Focus. I'm losing precious seconds. Characters represent groups, sequences. Okay. Sure. Nested. Garbage begins with this. Okay. It's a garbage. Oh man. This is deep. Each group assign a score. One more than a score. Total score. Okay, so this is gonna be interesting. Let's just see. Ah, okay. Today is gonna be tough, I think. I would say. Day 09. So the input is a string. Oh well, what can we parse this into? Group. Probably a group. I'm not sure if. Yeah, everything's probably in a group. There probably is not characters, just by themselves. Output is an integer. Hello, cat. I do have to write cat. So group is either garbage or group. Zero or more other things. Enter another group or garbage. I'm not really sure this is right, but I'll have to see later. So garbage has some ignored characters. But I don't think we can, or I don't think we should like put it there. So probably the meat of the function will be meat of the problem will be in the parse function, and people with some like peg grammar and so on will be better off. We'll see. Wow. I don't even know how to think about it. So, example one will be and this will be just garbage, and number of groups, so this is zero, I guess, because it's garbage. As a web programmer, I have really uneasy feeling doing this. Like so many unclosed things. Is that right? Okay. I'm sure there's gonna be so many like so many like edge cases. I'm not looking forward to that. So, okay, so those are garbages. Oh, wait. So, group which has nothing in it three groups So there's empty group, an empty group. Like, yeah, I definitely am, and it's surprising me. Like the getting up is getting easier, but like yesterday, you know, we had like a company, I don't know, like Christmas party or something. I don't know how to say it in English, but so I am surprised I got up. Yeah. So, what is this? Group. It contains a group which contains a group which is empty. Then there's another group. Then there's a group that contains a group. Wow. That's deep. example 12. Where am I? Okay. Come on, cat. A. Do I even have to think about a garbage? Well, like, I probably don't even need it here, but I wouldn't have a way to. I have to have some root node. I will keep it there, but. It's only complicating things, I think. I could do something like maybe group. Let's do it like this. Maybe group. So it's G, that means all these are nothing, 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 and this is gonna be G. So it's four groups in a row. This is two groups and it's. So this is cancelled. So this is still garbage. This is still garbage. This is still garbage. And the last thing is that. Okay, yeah, and I was wrong about this being the final score, so this is just the number of groups. Total score. Example 14. Score of 1. Oh, wait. We have it here, so I will ignore it. The three groups are 6. These are 5. A is 1. This is probably the same thing. And these are something I'll have to calculate. And then there's. This, which is a group, are those four groups? Yeah. four groups, nine. So these are also four groups, which makes it nine. And two groups, which makes it two, I guess. And last example, I think this is probably the boring part of the stream. I'm sorry, I just realized I'm maybe not doing the most viewer friendly thing. But you have a cat, so you must be happy. So these are okay, the cat's gone, it seems. So yeah, sure. It's probably the same thing as this one. Okay, so our unit tests are done and I hope they will be useful to us. So let's bring our runner here. Watch to 1709. So compute is wrong. We don't know yet. Parse. How to do it best? So in Elm we also have some kind of like parsers. I wonder if I just did it with like recursive functions or something. Can I do it? I'll have to remember some context, like am I in a garbage or did I just see like exclamation mark. What do I have to do? I think I'll try to use the Alma architecture as always. So context can be what? Either just in exclamation mark, in garbage. Do exclamation marks happen outside of garbage? Probably not. Groups are only. Okay, so. Right. Okay. But now let's see. Do I have to know the like the number of groups I was in? Maybe not. We'll see. I'm not sure we'll need it, but maybe it will be nice for some backtracking. I like looking back, I don't know. So we s split it into characters. So initial result is nothing, and you know when we get the group, it will be group, and we will have to think about what goes inside. I hope we don't blow the stack, which might be a thing that Eric put in there, like some big nice thing, but maybe not. From the input, I hope not. We'll see. So, oh yeah, and not group, but just group. Fault from the left. Sure. Characters result and context and parse character. Probably not on this level yet. I will. I think that the character parsing will have to come in later parts, but right now I have to like iterate on the function until on a function that reads arbitrary number of characters until it says it's done. So probably not a fault, but there's something recursive. But then if we just, you know, define these states, it seems like I should be able to go character by character. But I don't see how that's possible. At least in Elm, like maybe in Python, in some imperative language, I could maybe do that. I don't know. So for a lack of better word, parse helper.
So, let's see. We'll have to find. I wonder, can we go about it by reading the first character this right? Maybe car and string. So if nothing, we have empty string, empty string, and we can probably just return the result. And if it's just the square and rest of string, then so I think if we see closing bracket here, something's wrong. Probably wrong because we are. Well, we can be in garbage. I'm getting like thoughts of using regular expressions to just clear some of the garbage away and be left with groups. So I'm probably, not even sold on what I'm doing here. Maybe let's just think about the API. So, parse helper will do what? Does it really return input? If yes, we have to have another function that don't know, reads group, reads garbage. What would those be? Maybe a read,
which combines them. Let's just maybe think about like how do parsers work, because I'm not really well versed in that. Okay, I think I am like bailing out of my initial idea and just using the library. Okay. So parser. So just keep it, you know, there, but I think we're gonna try to parse differently. Oops. Uppercase P, parse input. So run parser on an input, which gives me result. Case okay, data is data. Okay, so let's just write that into pipeline style. So we do not have a parser, of course. And now, what will our parser be? So we will have parser of input, and let's just say, yeah, let's keep it there. Or maybe as a parser group. That makes more sense, I think. This will probably have to be. This will probably have to leave, because if there's not a group but there's a garbage, then we don't want to crash everything. So, keep. Or ignore. Oops. Group parser and what?
I do not even know. But I think it will be good to have it because we will be able to do something like ignore. Ignore garbage or something. Okay. Oops. What was that? Fine. Let's do symbols. P has to be group has to be symbol. Oh, it's this. And now what's the API of this? Keep value. So symbol, where is it? Where is it? It gives us unit. We want to transform it into group. Man, this is hard even to think about. And then maybe I should look at some examples of like parsing parentheses. Sequence. Oh. Okay. I am interested. Import for parser language git SPL. And now PL sequence. How does it work? So it's parser of X10A94. Wow, great. I'm not even started. Oh, like I probably would have managed to do something imperative in Python, but like in functional style, like I have trouble even like thinking about how I would do it. Okay, so start.
So, extend, what did you write it in? Rust. Nice choice, I imagine. Spaces are. We do not have any. We do not want any spaces, right? But we should probably put the garbage in there. So item. Great. I will probably try to find your source code later and look at it when I'm done. I am interested in seeing that. So item is parser A. So I think I can do this and great. I will look it up afterwards. List group list. So we can do this. So item is also a group. And trailing is. Do I even want to know what the shapes club is? Yeah. Awesome. Trailing. So trailing what? Separators? Trailing separators are forbidden. PL forbidden. And so we have to think about what garbage is. And garbage will be but no, probably zero or more. Zero or more. Okay, so this is I should probably write another sequence here. So does ignore no. So garbage starts with this, ends with this, and no, I can't do it this way because we have no way to do like the exclamation mark point, whatever. So we have to do it ourselves. Let's just quickly look at how the sequence thing works. Maybe that will give us some idea. Tuple sequence. Symbol start and then spaces and then sequence end, which is. Oh man. Okay, but there's not too bad. Okay, So, symbol is with strings. Symbol this. So these are probably like ignore, and these are keep them. So let's see again. If we see anything but either exclamation mark or ending bracket. So well, it looks pretty, but like for advent of code, like it only helps you with some of the problems. Like yesterday was great because it's just a pipeline and it's awesome, but like this, like I mean, what the hell is this? So, one of either what am I supposed to do later? And then, okay. So, symbol. Just switch them. Oops. I just switch them. And how can we end? And then succeed something. Parse end. Okay, yeah, symbol end. So, yeah, I was expecting it to be somewhere here. Symbol end, and then, okay. So, so what is end of garbage? What is chump press? Okay, here it is. Sequence end. Chump pressed. Okay, so it seems we have to succeed to end the parsing. Succeed with some value. Garbage is parser. Succeed this? I don't know. We'll see. And so we'll have to ignore one character and then do does the one off go sequentially? Okay, right? So here's some catch-all. And how can we do a catch-all? Ignore one what? Low level, let's see. Nope. Language kit. How can I do that? How many characters to keep or ignore? So, ignore. Okay, sure, right. Ignore. Or I can keep them, whatever. Ignore. P. One or more, I don't know. I'm guessing here. Character, because whatever else is fine. Or maybe just to be sure. So, not this, and not this. Okay. Can I somehow say, yeah, okay, exactly. Exactly one. Or maybe just one or more, it will probably be more efficient. So it will stop until these two come. So, ignore the car and then the rest of the garbage. So, P, ignore, P. Exactly one of whatever it is, P, and then it's gonna be this one. So, I hope it works. It probably doesn't, but we'll see. So, garbage. I should probably just keep it here. Okay. Okay, so what was that other thing? Is it just okay, ignore. I will use that. Do they? No, they don't expose it, but I will use it. Okay, and they do not expose it, right? And so what is the other one? Oh, okay. Right. So I don't know why they use like one thing and then expose it as some other thing. Not really sure. But it doesn't matter. We don't even probably use it. Oh, we do. So, okay, that's a bit nicer. So, one of group. Oh, yeah, because it's G. Okay, and I am defined in terms of itself, causing an infinite loop. Ooh. But I do want to use it. So if I do this, it's gonna be wrong, right? Yeah, sure. Oh, see, nice ASCII chart. Okay. How am I supposed to do that? Recursive. Lazy. Oh, great. Boolean uses Boolean in its own. Okay, lazy. Great. Uninteresting garbage. Sure. Okay, so I'm probably using the and then functions wrong somehow. Something like option group. Yeah, I do. I actually have that here, maybe group. But I'm kind of figuring out the parser thing. So if I did parser maybe group, then I would have to do one of either garbage or a group. Okay, let's try it, but garbage and group, and now group is this. But I feel like this, like using garbage as white space, should automatically like get rid of it for me. So I'm not sure. I'm torn. Which now makes the song stuck in my head. Let's see. How do they use? And then jump pressed item. Okay, yeah, so it uses whatever we just pipelined from. So the symbol should be ignored. And then this. And it's the uninteresting garbage, so test. Yeah, sure. Let's fix these tests. So oh man, I did everywhere. Yeah, I did everywhere. Oops. So let's do it again and better. So this goes like this, and goes like this. Okay. So only one error. What? Maybe input is maybe group. Result group. Like just. Okay, so we can see it's doing things wrong. I'd like to just start with the first example. It works, but I guess because it always returns nothing. So let's see. Sure. This should fail on the parse. Okay, so I want just G and it is nothing. Result is error. Expecting this. So it somehow wants spaces. Okay, yeah, so this wasn't a good idea. Spaces is garbage. Where else could I? So this is the only place I need it. So how can I say these are needed? How can I say these are optional? Sequence. spaces are here. Ignore zero or more character is this, but would if I want like the whole parser to be ignored. So sequence, let's just do it our way. Symbol this, and then sequence and ignore always in person. So one of either the thing or so garbage is also or is it not? I was thinking like garbage can be also divided by the comma, but probably not. So we're going to parse this symbol, that's good. Parse item. So item is item. Either garbage or group. Garbage is, I hope, fine. And then pa lazy group, and then chomp rest. So it will always be this sequence and forbidden. One of item and then chomp rest. So I feel space separators. Take this symbol. Read garbage or lazy group. So the and then
rest of the stuff. Rest of group. So it should read the separator and then either the group or the end. And the end should be this. Group, rest of group, lazy group. So does it help if I do this? Argument. So this seems to have helped. So garb, okay, I think we'll have to do stuff like maybe group. I'm not sure. Parser, maybe group. Maybe group. Okay, but this one, nope. But the other ones probably should. So that we can have in, we can return either the garbage or the group. It has this type. Okay. Second one is okay, so this one doesn't need it. I am, you know, confused about what operators need what. So garbage is tag.
type annotation for garbage says it is this, but it is this. So group left argument is supposed to be what? Symbol. I don't understand. Let's just read some other error. So, rest of the group. So this thing probably doesn't need the thing I need it, it does. But now it does. What is this? Okay, so oh, nope. So as you can see, I am really like stuck in a totally new area for me, totally new library. Symbol. Left argument should be. I'm sorry. Keep up the good fight. Okay. So it needs succeed and the function that will keep a value. Read about parser pipelines here. They are really nice. Oh, are they? So, okay. So if I ever use the pipe equals thing, I have to have a function that somehow consumes this thing. Okay. So maybe I just want it to be and then. If I, you know, wanted to ignore it. Stuff. So we take another. So from the example inputs, if we ever got a group, we cannot have comma and then another like garbage. It's gonna be all groups, I think. So garbage cannot be here, okay. So lazy group with so, okay, maybe do this. So add group to inner groups or add through the inner groups. So and is we succeed in groups. It should give us okay. No. It should give us parser of a group. It should look like this. Inner groups. We do not know at group two. Dude, I love this hook. I love this sush. I don't know it if it's from the closure function name. Add group two, so it gets list of maybe group and then parser what? It should probably end with the group as always. Parse a group. So it has to read a group. And okay, so this was definitely wrong. Because we cannot have comma and then end. So again, what's here? Inner group. So okay, one of.
one of next group or end, and this will be this would be the end. And here can only be lazy groups, or maybe just groups. If we are in a lambda, it should not matter that this is recursive or self-defining symbol. And then lazy group or group and then inner group rest of group. So it wants maybe group, rest of group. Okay, what? G is expecting list of maybe groups. Does it? It wants list of group. So what's wrong here? Let's just get rid of this. So okay, so G, let's do it like this. We have a list of maybes, so we can do filter map, which will make it into list of group. G P succeed. I'm great, I got it right. So are you like a closure person? First entry is garbage, second is group. So I have said the word group so many times, it's now sounding A, like the Groot from Guardians of the Galaxy, and B, it stops being a word for me, and I'm not even sure, like, you know, I don't know, did you have the feeling sometimes, like, you're saying a word and now you're like thinking about the letters and it's a nonsense, but it exists. It is somehow related to like the déjà vu, and there's some three other types of déjà vu like things. So, yeah, that happens. So, maybe group. Maybe group is gonna be maybe group. Or maybe just do oop, just so garbage is nothing by default. So okay, P
FPL, we do not need it. So it wants to be group into something, but we are giving it maybe group. All right, maybe group. Okay, so it's basically the same thing as before. What? What? So I don't know. What is this? Does it happen on any input? It doesn't. Okay, so the nothings are probably still fine, but what about the group? So we did not even get this far. Let's just see whether somebody get this issue too. Parser. So issues. JS exception. Okay, so probably not. Compilation error when using lazy parsers. It could be something. Oh yeah, this should be it. So let's see. By the way, this guy is also running Advent of Code. So great to see you here. Now I randomly added one more lazy. We could have defined languages. Okay. Boy. Okay, so let's just maybe sprinkle lazy everywhere. Oh. And it got closer, so that helped. Source is this. It expected this symbol on column 2. Why? So I don't allow. Okay, yeah, I should probably allow empty group. So maybe and so yeah, and it's always empty. So clone three. Clone three is like and like the end of file, end of line, whatever. So it is somewhere here. Reach the end of string. So so I'm probably using this this library wrong because I'm using p and then everywhere and not those these things. That will have to sit a bit in my head and maybe, you know, I'll get a light bulb like tomorrow. We'll see. So and wait, B map. Yeah, sure. Inner groups is the better. Why doesn't it let me? Let me end. So let's try it differently. So let's try the pipeline style. I think I have to do it like this, and then I have to somehow find the list. So I ignore the start of the list, start of the group, and I keep this. So Inside group. Inside group is one of these. So it only takes I think that's right. So garbage cannot be done like this. So only one garbage, and I'm not sure about this yet. So garbage is okay, and bloop. Inner groups is puzzle list group, so it has to end with this and the string. So groups, what is groups? I just put the end here. Groups doesn't take anything and gives us parser of list groups. So it's p lazy this, how can I do it? If I want to use group, I think this thing has to be already recursive. So so again, how do they build the list? Sequence end. Just out of curiosity, to always keep parser in a parser.
Okay. Keep pass, ignore pass. It's probably the same thing, but I don't understand. So, groups. Okay, let's look at it again. Sequence. It ignores these things and goes with sequence and. Okay, so let's just try to. Always. Yeah, so map to should probably be map to maybe group. So now let's do it. Let's do it like they do it here. Symbol start. We already have it. Sequence end. Oh, so maybe we don't need it really. Maybe we have to do here just the sequence end thing, whatever it is. Okay. One off and symbol or and succeed this. So we are kind of doing that here, maybe. So one off. Right, or parse an item and while chunk pressed, why not another sequence end? Yeah, because they are thinking about the do they allow spaces or not? Jump first item. And so parse item is what? Parse item is the group. Okay, so I think we are better off having that here. So group. And then something with the this. So
So next group G. So next group has what does it return list? Maybe in rest of group. Inner groups either next group or the end. Okay, that makes sense. And next group is symbol. So how did they do it? Then rest of group. I'm really unsure about this. So, item, where do they add this? Jump rest. So we don't want this, but G rest of groups. Okay, so maybe just try this. Group so far. First one is maybe, second one is list, so this is gonna be like this. Groups is not a function. Awesome. So isn't this the thing Elm was supposed to keep me from? Groups is not a function. Groups. Come on. Rest of group.
Inner groups. So why doesn't it see this? Let's just look into the JavaScript. So we are in the inside group. Inside group. Says groups that do not exist, but they do. What? Okay, so all right. Okay, so we got further than I expected, but I don't know why it does not allow me in a group. T groups. Group so far is 0. I'm doing this. Why the heck? If do I use groups later? Yes, I do. And so why does it not exist? Because it's defined afterwards. Shouldn't it be like not matter? It doesn't matter. It still doesn't work. So so lazy everywhere? Is it what you want from me? Int help? What? I am probably not reading the same file. Or like it's stale. Okay, here it is. Parser, internal parser. Okay. 3560, that's it. 3615, parser 1. A2 is helper, parse. Result, yeah, sure. What is this? Okay, again, how do they do it? jump rest. One off separator and then the next thing or the end.
So it's separator and then the next thing or the end. Okay. So it was this, which was jump rest, and now the item and then the rest or the end. So the item and the rest, I have it. So again,
so item and then the rest.
So this one doesn't get any like empty list. They will get it on the second step. So let's see. So group, which will have to be lazy, and then jump rest, which is comma and rest with the thing. Okay. Comma and rest will be sequence and forbidden. So either the end so separator, okay. We do not have spaces.
and then compressed, which is this thing. Is the same error? Come on. So, what can we make lazy? So. So we made this lazy. Not help. Why do I have the feeling it will not help? Hi, Chandu. What can we do? What can we do? Recursively defined values. What distro or manager are you using? So I'm using Elementary OS, which is built on Ubuntu, but it doesn't use GNOME or something. It uses Gala, I believe, which is their own thing. So they basically just use the base system from Ubuntu and build all the UI from scratch, or I don't know. They are kind of reusing GTK and some GNOME stuff, but I'm mainly using it because I have 4K display and it's like the one thing, one system or distribution that, you know, can handle 4K display and a 4K external monitor. So I'm using it. Before I used Ubuntu or Xubuntu with i3, which was nice because of tiling, but didn't work much with the 4K display. So that was on a different laptop. Cannot read property of. Run on the group.
So, okay, let's just do lazy everywhere. We're going crazy. Okay. And also, it seems something has fixed it. It is expecting and it is on. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So are we missing group ending somewhere? Let's just try to remove this thing. Okay, so it did something. Let's see. Does it get here? It does. Okay, so our parser is. Okay, our parser is not all right. column 6. So 1. Oh, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so there are spaces. Can there be spaces, or was that just mine idea? There are not. So that's my mistake. What? Bars. So, G. So again, what's the G has a list of group. Maybe that's just my mistake. So the third one is closed, then there's a closed one, then there's one with one inside it. Okay, yeah, I think I know what's wrong. I have to reverse the list afterwards. So. Let's do this. And then we are green again. So let's see the garbage. So it did not see the garbage coming. So where can we put garbage? Did we even use it anywhere? Inside a group. There can be a garbage. Right. It's expecting. Why is it expecting the garbage here? Don't care. I'll just put it there. So this So now column 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What? So maybe it's one based. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So so it did not see the end symbol going after the content of the garbage. So uninteresting garbage should be so he succeeds this, ignore this, and ignore this. Okay. So it passed into this. Uninteresting garbage. Okay, so let's maybe just try it like this. So it still ignores the rest. So how should we think about it? Ignored character. We didn't even get to the we didn't even get to the exclamation marks. So it probably eats all the stuff. Just debug it. So A is not interesting and this is interesting. Okay, so that works. So ignore one or more things that are not interesting. Okay. And then okay, yeah, sure.
So this whole thing could be thought of as inside garbage. So we are just moving, we are just skipping the uninteresting stuff. And we should probably put the end thing here. Yeah, it's horrible. Like three was hard, but this is so much harder. But you know, I'm kind of mad at myself for not figuring out like the like functional recursive thing that just eats characters and moves to the next thing. I just went for the library, which I don't know how to use, so yeah, good times. P1 off. Yeah. Okay. That's true. So, list of groups. Okay, so I will give you this. Definition shown above is so finite state machine. That is not that bad idea. Oh man. Like, I could have probably did it using finite state machine, but it did not occur to me to like use it. So I will just continue to learn the parser stuff. G. So, what's wrong here? Ignore character. Oh, hey, hey. No, it's all right. No harm done. I'm obviously not going for leaderboards, so yeah, the cat is great. So D -d 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 So why does it ignore everything then? We get a garbage. we get a garbage and like, do we even get to the next group after we do this? So can I somehow debug get position get source? So get position. I probably can at least print it at each level, right? So, wait a second. So, again, because today's problem got so long, my family got up and I'm now being a responsible parent. So, this is my daughter. Her name is Ellen. And so I wonder, I should probably let this problem be for a while. And just get back to it later, maybe do it with FSM. But I am so close. I don't know why this just ignores the rest of the group. So yay, pair programming, hooray. So I feel like I'm being close, but FSM will probably be better, like to like finish anytime soon. So I'll probably do another stream. I don't know when, but I will just start from scratch and use finite state machine and see where I get. So like I at least kind of found out how the parcel library works, so at least I learned something. But we're gonna do it another way. And so sorry that you did not see me finish today, but like this problem really got me stumped, and I'm sure like in the few days that the advent code will be still running, there will be many more puzzles that I can't just go boom 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 and do it. So, yeah, I will think about it and I will stream again and I will finish this. So, thanks everybody, and thank you for staying so long. So, goodbye.